I would like to share a small thought from Matthew chapter 8 and 9. Matthew chapter 8 and 9. I will be going through a few incidents happened in those two chapters. When we study the Word of God, the ministry of Jesus, he did three different kinds of ministry, which we can see in the Gospels. Jesus healed so many sick people, number one. Number two, he cast out demons. Number three, he preached the kingdom of God. Today, I'm going to share four or five incidents Jesus healed the sick people while he was on the earth. Matthew chapter 8, verses 1 through 4, a leper came to Jesus and he said, "Jesus, if you like, I will get healed." When we study the Word of God, God gave us so many laws in the books of Leviticus. One of the laws we can see there in the Leviticus book, chapter 13, verses 45 and 46, it's about the lepers. In that chapter, when we read that, God's commandment is, if a person become leper, he must wear a torn cloth. In those two verses, you go and read, you can see that then he has to cover the lower part of their face and cry out, "I'm unclean, I'm unclean." Number three, he must always remain unclean. Number four, he must live alone. Number five, he must live outside the camp. That was the general condition of a leper. That's one of the leper in that condition came to Jesus. He was not allowed to come in public. He was not allowed to come and acquaint with other people. But he knew Jesus can heal him. So he heard that Jesus is walking through. Jesus is coming to the town. This leper came to Jesus and said, "Master, if you like, I can get healed." I just want to show you that his desire, if Jesus likes that situation to heal me, Jesus can heal me. But when you read the next verses, Jesus touched him and healed him. The society, the laws of Moses don't allow him to come in public. Don't allow anybody to touch that leper. But we can see the love of Jesus towards that leper. The leper was told, his desire was only, "Jesus, if you want, I can get healed." But he could have said a word. Instead of, Jesus came down and touched him, he got healed. My dear brothers and sisters, those who are listening to me this morning, let me tell you, there's no other love in the world other than Jesus Christ. He came to this world. God gave his only begotten Son to this world because he loves you and me. Whatever situation you are going through, whatever need you have in your heart this morning, his love is in our midst. He touched that leper and healed him. When we go forward in that same chapter, we can see another person in verses 8. A centurion came to Jesus And his desire is, his servant was sick. And he wanted his servant to be healed. He came to Jesus, said, my servant is sick. We know if our child is sick, we are very desired to get him healed or her healed. If a family member is sick, we are so worried. Even a church member is sick, we are so worried. Here a centurion, a man came to Jesus and his desire is his servant is sick. He wants him to get sick, get healed. You know, this man is a centurion. He's a ranking man. He worked as an officer in the army, Roman army. 100 soldiers are reporting to him. He's a ranking man. He's a respected man. He got respected by all other people. He was a rich man. He was a royal man. This man is in that level of his life. He was so concerned about his servant. He knew, if I go to Jesus, my servant will get healed. So he came to Jesus even though he was a ranking man, he was a respected person, he was a rich man, he was a royal man, but he came to Jesus to get his servant healed. Why I said he was a rich man, that same incident, we can see that in Luke chapter 7, verses 2 to 10, it is recorded there. And when the people came to Jesus, they told so many things about this centurion. One of the things they said is recorded there. They said he deserved it. Number two, the people around him said he loves our people. Number three, he built a synagogue for us. You know, Roman people and Jewish people, like Sam said, you know, they were not in good harmony on those days. But this centurion, this noble man, this royal man, this rich man, he loved the Jewish people. And he built a church. He built a synagogue for them. And every people around him, they had a good testimony to tell him, a good opinion. He says, if you, Lord Jesus, if you want to heal the servant of this guy, he deserves it. My dear brothers and sisters, we are worshiping the Lord this morning in this sanctuary. Everybody is watching us. This man, the centurion, the people around him had a good testimony about him. We can see a high opinion about this man around the people, those who are around him. And when he heard Jesus can heal him, he said, Lord, I don't deserve you to come to my house. I said he is a centurion. He has 100 soldiers reporting to him. He's a rich man. He's a respected man. But his opinion about himself, Lord, I don't deserve you to come to my roof, under my roof. I'm not worthy for you to come to my house. This morning, while we are gathering here, that should be our attitude. Whatever we have in our life, it is by the grace of God. You have health, that's by the grace of God. If you have education, that's because of the grace of God. If you have children, that's because of the grace of God. Whatever you possess in your life, it is not by your merit. It is by the grace of God. The centurion says, Lord, I don't deserve it. You, God of Everybody, I don't deserve. I am not worthy for you to come to my house. He has a humble opinion. When everybody is saying a high opinion about this centurion, he's saying a humble opinion. Lord, I am not worthy for you to come to my house. When we read the next verses, Jesus, after hearing what he said, Jesus said a holy opinion about him. Jesus said, I tell you, I have not found such a great faith even in Israel. This man is a Roman man. He came to Jesus. His opinion was so humble about him. And he said, Lord, if you say a word, my servant will get healed. The first person, a leper, came to Jesus. He said, if you like, I will get healed. But Jesus touched him. This man, even though Jesus was okay to go to his house, but he stopped. Lord, you don't have to come to my house. I'm not worthy for you to come to my house. Just to say a word, my servant will get healed. By listening that, this man went back to his house and he saw that his servant got healed. His desire was Jesus to say a word for my servant. Jesus did. This morning, whatever desire in your heart, if you pray, our Lord is going to answer your prayer. This centurion, this man, a great man, he wanted that Jesus say a word for his servant. Jesus did, and he got healed. When we continue with the next chapter, chapter 9, verses 1 through 8, we can see another paralyzed man. Four people found this man somewhere, and they brought Jesus to him. They brought this man to Jesus. You know, that also happened in Capernaum, the same place. And we read that more detail in Mark chapter 2, verses 1 through 11. So many people came to the house of Capernaum because Jesus healed so many people. There was no room inside the house or outside the house. So when these four people found this paralyzed man, they brought him to Jesus. There was no room to bring him into the house or even outside. So what they did? They went up to the roof. They dig a hole. All the four people worked together and they brought that man in front of Jesus. When you read, after seeing their faith, Jesus healed him. This morning, let me tell you, if you like to bring somebody to Jesus, if you have the faith in your life, if you get together in faith, if you work together, our Lord can answer our prayers. Probably that person may not have that faith. The paralyzed man may not be believing in that. But if you get together in one accord and one mind, I tell you, our Jesus can heal that person. This morning also, he is in our midst. So the four people brought that man to him, to Jesus. After seeing their faith, he healed him. So, Jesus knew what the faith they have in their life. After seeing their faith, Jesus was able to heal that person. Let me go forward. The same chapter 9, verses 18 through 26, we can see a synagogue leader coming to Jesus. The situation is much more worse. His daughter passed away, and he wanted Jesus to come to his house and touch his daughter so that she may get alive. His faith is, you should come to my house, touch my daughter so that she can get healed. Jesus on his way. He went to the synagogue's leader's house, and there were so many people on the way. We can see in the same chapter, verses 20 through 22, a woman subject to bleeding for 12 years. That's an emergency situation. Jesus is going to the leader's house, synagogue's leader's house, but there is an emergency situation. A woman is subject to bleeding for 12 years. She was with the doctors for so many years. She went to different doctors. She spent everything she had. All the money she had, she spent for the healing. Nothing happened. She heard about Jesus. And she thought, if I go and touch the hem of the garment of Jesus, I will get healed. She thought, Jesus doesn't have to touch me. Jesus doesn't have to pray for me. Only thing I want, I should go and touch his garment. Then I will get healed. We see in the same chapter, after spending all the money, her health was deteriorating. She didn't have any more money to spend. She went from one doctor to another doctor, from one test to another test. In this age, we know so many tests, so many kind of from one doctor to another doctor, from one physician to specialist. That kind of situation happened to this lady for 12 years. She was going through all kind of trouble, but she was sick all these 12 years. Her faith was, I need to go to Jesus. I don't have to see him. Somehow, I have to touch his garment. She went through the crowd. She touched the garment of Jesus Christ. She immediately got healed. And when we read that portion, we can see Jesus knew that the power went through him, and he was asking, who touched me? And she came forward and she got healed. But let me come back to the leader of the synagogue. That time after this lady got healed, Jesus went to the house of the leader of the synagogue. His name is Jairus. And he reached the house. He pulled all the people out. And he went to the daughter of that synagogue leader, and he touched her, and he healed her. Not only healed her, that girl, daughter of that leader, came to life. And whatever the desire that man has had in his heart, Jesus fulfilled. This morning, let us meditate 1 minute. Our Lord is able to fulfill the desire of our heart. That leper came to Jesus. His desire was, Lord, if you willing, I can get you. But beyond his desire, Jesus went down and touched him. This morning, your situation, whatever you have, God is willing to work on your life. Probably your friends, your relatives, they may not know what you are going through, but Jesus knows. Praise God. Centurion, he was so concerned about his servant. He came to Jesus. Lord, if you say a word, my servant will get healed. This morning, God's word is so powerful. Wherever the situation you are going through, maybe people sick in your home, maybe a situation you cannot get an answer right now, but God's word can make an answer to your situation this morning. It may be a financial situation. Maybe your health situation. God can answer you. Four people brought a paralyzed man. Jesus found their faith. He got healed. That person got healed. And the other thing, we see that the lady with issues of blood for 12 years, she wanted to touch the garment of Jesus. She got healed. The leader of the synagogue, Jairus, wanted Jesus to come to his house and touch his daughter. Same thing Jesus did. Let's close our eyes. This morning, whatever the situation you have in your life, our Jesus is able to touch you and minister to your life and heal you and give answers whatever you have. I thank Sam, Pastor Sam, for giving me this opportunity to share the word of God in front of you. May God bless you.